everyone. Welcome to Talent Battle. Today, in our group discussion series, we will be talking about democracy versus monarchy. As usual, we will be having four parts, that is the introduction, democracy, monarchy, and the conclusion. Now first, let's go to the introduction. Why was government necessary? Government's history may not be exactly known, but it is safe to say that the government is as old as the human society itself. At some point in the past, as the population grew in a particular area, there was pressure to have a system of laws that the society members had to follow, since chaos would arise in a society if there was no governing body to set the guidelines to its constituents. Public order and maintenance of the security is vital to every society. The types of government. All the societies are established under some form of power or government, which varies from one country to another. It should also be noted that the government is constantly changing, as the history has shown. Today, we will talk about the two most popular forms of government, that is the democracy and monarchy. Democracy. Democracy in a nutshell is a type of government of the people, for the people, and by the people. In a democracy, power is vested in the citizens of the country to elect a government, and the government is thus answerable to the people. Monarchy. Monarchy is a form of government which was very common during the ancient and the medieval times. Here, only one person will be the main authority in the ruling country. In general, the monarchy's position is inherited. The people of the country have no say on electing their ruler. Now first, let's talk about the democracy. The principle of democracy. Democracy is based on a principle of equality and freedom. Equality is defined in terms where all the citizens are equal before the law. Basically, positions and statuses do not matter. When one breaks the law, he or she is subjected to sanctions. People gain a sense of participation in the process of choosing their government. Now let's talk about the pillars of democracy. The democracy is built with four pillars: the legislative, the executive, the judiciary, and the press or the newspaper. The legislative. The legislative pillar basically is responsible for making the laws that will govern a state. These laws are either formed directly by the people, that is the direct democracy, or through representatives elected by the people, that is indirect democracy. Executive. This pillar of democracy is responsible for implementing the laws formed by the legislative section and issues the order for their proper implementation. Judiciary. It keeps a check on the laws given by the legislatives and the orders issued by the executives and ensures that these laws and order do not curtail the fundamental rights of the citizen of a country. Press or the newspaper. It ensures the transparency in the working of the above three pillars. Now, let's look at the benefits of democracy. A timely election is held, and if the people are not satisfied with the performance of the present government, they can change the government in the next election. This forces the present government to work efficiently, else they will lose the power in the next election. For a successful democracy, apart from a successfully elected government by majority, a good opposition is equally required. It keeps a check on the ruling party's work and opposes whenever required. The role of media. Media is also very crucial in a democracy, and the freedom of press is one of the measures of the extent of democracy in a country. It has the duty to bring into light the ground reality, and with its wide reach, it can raise the concerns of a common man. Now, let's see what is monarchy. The monarch. The supreme power is bestowed on an individual, and it can be absolute or nominal. The head of the state of a land with this kind of government often holds the title for life or until its abdication. The leader, who is called as a monarch, is wholly set apart from all the other members of the state. The monarch typically makes all the laws and decisions. Inefficiency of the ruler. The ruler may form policies which are beneficial for him but not for the country, or the ruler may be incapable of performing his duties efficiently. Still, nothing can be done by the people. The system of inheritance can also lead to inefficiency at times, as the ruler and his generation have the security of their future whether they perform or not. No need of frequent elections. The huge expenditure of elections is saved and the decision-making process is very fast. There is no need to conduct frequent elections as the entire country is handled by a single person only. Types of monarchy. There are two types of monarchies. The first is constitutional and the second is elective. In constitutional monarchy, it is the one where the power of the monarch is significantly limited and the true national supremacy is likely to lie with the elected government. An elective monarchy. An elective monarchy is the one where the monarch is actually elected by the people for a specific term as the head of their state. But still in elective monarchy, one person holding the supreme authority can be dangerous. Now, let's go to the conclusion. Democracy versus monarchy. After studying both types of government, it can be logically inferred that democracy is better than a monarchy. But a flawed democracy is a threat to the rights and justice of the people. Choosing a responsible leader. Handing over the responsibility of the entire country on one monarch is potentially risky. Instead, having a group of people to make these decisions seems to be fair. Any power in any modern nation should be put into the hands of someone who is accountable to the people of the nation and laws of the land. The governance is most important factor for the proper functioning of a country. Thus, the government and its leaders should have checks and balances and must be transparent as much as possible. Thank you.